Welcome back, metalheads, straight back from the break, with Dave and Chuck from Megadeth.
Yes!
Hello.
How you doing, boys?
Fine, yourself?
Europe's been waiting a long time for Megadeth, and here we are.
At last, I told you, one day we'd catch these guys. And it has to be one of the biggest events in the world, the Donington Monsters Rock. You guys are going on very shortly. How do you feel? A little bit tense?
Cold. It's freezing here today.
Yeah, you guys get it too hot over there, you know what I mean? You get all the sunshine, we get all the rain.
Yeah, well, I'd like to trade you for some right now.
You're looking forward to going on stage, Chuck?
Oh, yeah, man. This is like lifetime ambition.
You've been looking forward to doing it?
Oh, yeah, Remember the Rainbow album?
Oh, yeah.
I used to listen to that, man, and be like, yeah. Rainbow. And now I'm playing it, it's like, shh.
Well, Rainbow was the first band headline this event.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Dave, is this the biggest event Megadeth have ever played?
I've played a lot bigger in my dreams, but...
Yeah, haven't we all?
What's
bigger than this?
Well, we won't get into that.
No, okay.
This is seriously the biggest thing we've done.
Yeah.
Hopefully it won't be the last.
Having said that, though, your album so far, So What, So Good, has done some really good sales. I don't know what the official figure is, but I mean, every time we talk to some rock fans, they've bought your album. You've created quite a big following. To say you don't really play over here that often in Europe, you've got a big following.
Yeah, we try not to exploit ourselves. A lot of bands, they burn themselves out by doing that. And I think it's better to leave them wanting more than, give them too much.
What? Go on, mate.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Dave, the cover versions, will you be dropping them in the near future? Or are you going to stick to some more cover versions?
It depends. We never set out to do a cover. It's always just been something we've done, and it just ends up sneaking on the record.
Then it's working well for you, Chuck.
How do you prepare for a gig like this then, Chuck? Because it's obviously
just like
different.
You lay back, man.
I have a couple of Vodka Sevens. I'm looking in the crowd for some girls.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, you're looking for some girls, will you?
Yeah, I saw two nice blondes on the way in.
Oh, yeah.
What about Japan?
How did that go for you? That's strange.
Strange.
Have they started moshing yet?
Well, sort of, yeah.
They're supposed to like sit down and like fold their hands and it can only scream after a song, but a lot lately for us they've been moving around. I know a lot of people that have come over here and done concerts here. I mean, I've been to Japan and it's still been kind of basically the same, but I don't know. It's always a blast going over there because it's such a cultural shock.
Well,
yeah.
Action here. And I've had to move back because you can't get Chuck on camera. I mean, this is Chuck's here. you can't look at this. You can't look at this because I'm going to ask you, have you got any new videos coming on the screen soon?
Well, we did record a video for In My Darkest Hour, but some people chickened out on playing it because they said it was about suicide, so we won't get into that, but the newest video we have right now is Anarchy in the UK, and we filmed that with English audiences to give it more of a feeling for it. We had a Steve Jones from the Sex Pistols playing it too, so it's about as crossed over American English as you can get. We've taken a little tidbit. I mean, there's not much more we can get English in that besides English vinyl.
Well, we play it, Dave, on our road shows, and it goes down really well, Des.
Yeah.
A really tremendous response to that particular cover version.
Do you find playing in Europe, do you have to change your show slightly? Is it a different audience, or do you prefer Europe to playing?
I prefer Europe over it.
What the hell's up in here?
Just like Jack.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. Stately Roth. He always has to get in on the acts.
We've got to wind up. Just one quick question. Megadeth, the name Megadeth. This European audience been asking the Bailey Brothers, what's the meaning behind the name?
Extremely bad breath. No, what it is
mega breath.
It's mega breath, yeah.
It's supposed to mean a million deaths. When I came home from New York before I started Megadeth, I was thinking of a name that would represent the band, you know, with the utmost heaviest, ultra furious kind of moniker that would just like, you know, you'd go, ah.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's better than, you know, something. I don't know.
Okay, Dave, Chuck.
Have a great gig.
You've got to go on stage very soon, so we've got to wind up. Would you pick a video for the lads?
Getting ready.
And for the viewers?
Okay, we're getting ready.
Well, you want to see Anarchy in the UK?
Yeah.
Okay,
all right, sorry.
That
okay.
Sounds good to us, Chuck.
Anarchy in the UK. Thanks a lot. Good luck today.
Should be good.
Cheers.
This song is about God, about the system of things, about getting to work on time, about paying your bills, about having feelings, about being kind, about not being kind. You know what I'm talking about? Julia! Well, for those of you that don't, we'll give you one more clue with the bass guitarist, David Ellison.